Hi, thanks for joining another video. Today we're going in depth on what a DC fast charger is and how it works. In this video, we will be specifically looking at Tesla superchargers and talking about what the differences are between the different chargers. If you're just looking to get some basic info about EV charging, I suggest you check out my EV 101s video. However, if you're curious to learn a little more about DC fast chargers and the Tesla charging network, then stick around. All right, let's dive in. Why are DC fast chargers important? Superchargers, like all DC fast chargers, are very important for long distance travel. Driving around the country will most likely deplete your charge, even in a long range EV. These chargers help you get back to driving, as their name implies, fast. A Tesla supercharger can range from 54 kilowatts to 250 kilowatts as of 2021 at least. Most recently, it was announced that the supercharger network would be upgraded to 300 kilowatts soon. A question new EV owners ask is, do I need to get a supercharger installed in my garage? Luckily, that is probably the easiest question to answer. No. You don't need it, and your home doesn't have the amount of power to support that. Regular level 2 charging is plenty to give you a full charge within a few hours. Let's start with some basics and build upwards to superchargers. There are two different types of power, AC and DC. AC, or alternating current, is constantly fluctuating. This helps power travel long distances and can easily have its voltage stepped up or down. Almost all electricity running through the US grid uses AC power. There are a few exceptions, but they're not important right now. DC, or direct current, doesn't fluctuate. Its power stays consistent. The power in the walls of your home is AC, but to store this electricity in your car, it first needs to be converted to DC. This is because batteries charge with and output DC power. The power conversion can be done two ways. One with your onboard charger or with a DC fast charger. Let's go over how both of these work. A level 1 or level 2 charger is a very simple piece of equipment. You might look at the power brick on the wall and say, that's charging my car. It's actually not doing very much of anything. The technical term for this box is an EVSE, which stands for Electric Vehicle Supply Equipment. In this box, there is a very basic computer and a relay. The computer is used primarily for safety. This computer monitors ground, voltages, maximum amperage, and typically temperature. When the plug end of the charger isn't plugged into the car, the pins aren't connected to power. This is a safety measure so that you don't accidentally shock yourself by touching the plug. It's also to prevent arcing when plugging in the car. The car must first communicate with the charger before any electricity comes available. When plugged in, the EVSE will tell the car how much power it's able to supply. Once the car is ready to charge, it'll send a signal to the charger and the relay will close the circuit. A level 2 charger is basically like a light switch attached to a computer. At this point, AC power is fed into your car, where your onboard charger will convert this power from AC to DC. DC fast chargers work a little bit differently. Similarly to the EVSE, the pins on a supercharger are not live for safety. When plugging in, the car will negotiate with the computer and the supercharger. Information about your car will be sent back and forth for billing purposes, as well as information about your current charge level. Once all of that is cleared, the charging process begins. When DC fast charging your car, the power bypasses your onboard charger and goes directly into the battery. The DC charging rate with DC chargers isn't as consistent as it is with a wall unit because the battery in the car is more likely to heat up. The car will be in constant communication with the charger to tell it how much power it's able to accept. The supercharger must never go above the amount of power the car can accept, or there will be a risk of damaging the battery. Tesla superchargers, like all DC fast chargers, convert three-phase AC electricity to high-voltage DC electricity. Tesla superchargers run on a 480-volt DC standard. This is because all Tesla packs are in the 400-volt range. Some have a higher and lower nominal voltage, but none of them have issues charging at this voltage. There are a few other EVs out there with 800-volt or even 1,000-volt packs, but so far Tesla has not shown any interest in the higher voltage battery configurations. Since most DC fast chargers in general are already in the 400-volt range, cars with higher voltage packs often have to step up the power themselves in order to charge on the lower voltage fast chargers. But that's a topic for another video. Now to break down some of the magic behind the supercharger. In a version 2 supercharger, Tesla isn't really using any specialized equipment. In fact, there have been some pictures inside of the supercharger cabinet, and what people found was just a whole bunch of Tesla Model S onboard chargers. They literally just stacked a bunch of extra chargers, and that's pretty much it. Since then, the version 3 superchargers have come out, and these no longer use onboard chargers to convert the power, but are now their own specialized units. Over the years, Tesla has updated and improved their chargers to give end users faster charging. Originally, superchargers could give 90 kilowatt of output. For 2012, this was pretty amazing. DC charging at this time was in its infancy. Not too much longer after that, version 2 emerged, which allowed for 120 kilowatt charging. The actual chargers behind this could output either 135 or 145 kilowatt depending on their age. Each charger could be shared between two cars. So if one person plugged in and was getting 100 kilowatts and a second car could pull up and they'd get 35 or 45 kilowatts until the first car started to fill up. This worked, but it was a little frustrating if you ended up getting on a slow stall. If you look at version 2 stalls, they're always labeled 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B. The number indicates the charging cabinet you're connected to. A tip with these chargers is to stay off the same number that somebody else is using. Later, these chargers were updated to be able to provide their full output to a single stall, so long as a second stall wasn't occupied. This allowed stalls to charge very close to 150 kilowatts. Another sidestep for version 2 was the addition of urban superchargers. These chargers output 72 kilowatts. In the cabinet, they're exactly the same, built using the 145 kilowatt charger. The only difference is that each stall is guaranteed to be able to get 72 kilowatts. If you quickly do the math, 72 times 2 is 144, just below 145 kilowatts. If you've ever seen an urban supercharger on a pallet, these are typically temporary installs that Tesla puts in just before a supercharger site is expanded. They put these in so they can increase capacity at busy chargers while they plan out an upgrade. These pallet superchargers typically max out at 54 kilowatts, though I've seen ones that are capable of 72 kilowatts. Just depends on the location, I guess. Next, we make the big leap to version 3. Version 3 cabinets are rated for 1 megawatt of power, with each stall getting 250 kilowatts each. The cables on these chargers are also much thinner because they are liquid cooled. They're so much easier to handle, it's really nice. Tesla has started making prefabricated supercharger sites as well. This should help them to reduce the cost and amount of time it takes to roll out new chargers. Now, at the version 3 announcement, Elon said that these chargers wouldn't share power like old version 2 chargers. That's sort of true, but also not, since we know that each supercharger cabinet provides power to 4 stalls, so they're still sharing, right? I wouldn't be surprised if they came out with new cars which could accept a faster charging rate, and then they'd update the stalls to output even more, similar to how they did with version 2. These megawatt chargers are also suspected to be used as a single stall for the Tesla Semi. There are over 25,000 Tesla superchargers globally. Traveling with a Tesla is pretty fun, especially if you encounter a supercharger in an interesting location. Let me show you some of my favorite spots that I have encountered so far. These chargers are at Courtside, Arizona. Recently, version 3 superchargers were added to this site. I came twice to this site to see the progress in the construction, and drone footage was taken of it. Each one of these pipes in the ground carries the high voltage wires from the supercharger cabinet to the stall where you plug in your car. These white boxes are the supercharger cabinets that still need to be installed. This site greatly needed an expansion because it frequently had long lines around holidays. I'm glad that they upgraded this site. This is Kettleman City in California, and this is one of the Tesla supercharger spots. They have 40 stalls, and you can charge from 150 kilowatts or over there in the back, 250 kilowatts. This is a pretty neat spot because they have a Tesla cafe, and in order to gain access to the Tesla cafe, you need to look at the code that's inside your car. But inside, there's a cafe, they sell some shirts, and there's restrooms. And also another thing is that blue Model Y that's right in the front has a QR code. You just scan it and you can take it for a test drive while you charge. So it's a pretty neat charging spot. This is Harris Ranch, California, and I'm standing in front of one of the first locations where they placed superchargers. It started off with only one supercharger, then they expanded to 6, and now it has 18. But it seems like they're actually going to expand this one even further to probably have one of the locations with the most superchargers. Harris Ranch is also the location where Tesla tested their first public battery swap station. This option was not popular with owners, so the project was abandoned. You can also find a Tesla Roadster charger here. Pretty neat. I'm in Baker, California, and behind me are Tesla superchargers and Electrify America charging stations. And off to the side, there's gas fueling stations. This Tesla supercharger has 40 stalls.
These are the chargers at the SpaceX facility in Hawthorne, California. Unfortunately, this site will be closing to the public soon.
I hope that was informative, and as always, thanks for spending time with me today. Make sure to subscribe for more EV content and follow me on social media at CallasEV and CallasTesla. Calla is my dog. And check out my website for more EV resources at CallasEV.com. That's all for now, and happy charging.